You talked a lot at the beginning and kind of sprinkled throughout of like working with the military and how there are sometimes these situations where it just needs to be like a logical reaction. Like there's no emotion, we're just making the decision, or maybe there's some kind of protocol, like, if emergency break glass or whatever it might be, it's just like, you react. So if someone is in a situation like that, whether it's for, that's just the way this job, if someone's police, fire, rescue, whatever, or maybe there's a certain deadline and it's like, we have to get this done no matter what in the next 5 days. So regardless of the timeline, if someone's in that situation, it's kind of like, well, this is how it is. How do you help them turn that on and off? So for instance, I'm going to go home and I'm going to have the good relationship with my family, knowing that I'm going to go back to work and go back into the like protocol kind of intellect only, but then also turn it back off again when I go home. And so not finding yourself intellecting only at home or emoting at work when neither one of those things work. So what kind of either tools or tips for people to kind of like tune the radio dial back and forth from different stations?
That's such a great question. So if you think back to one of the first slides I showed, there was a little guy with a balance beam on a tightrope. So the reality is that this balance is something we all have to do all the time. Sometimes you need to lean a little bit one way or the other, depending on the situation that you're in as a leader. And so I would say the way to turn that on and off is super, super intense self-awareness. What am I doing? Who am I with? And what are the consequences of the way I'm going to act? So, for example, if you need to act quickly, make a big decision without considering other people's feelings, there might be consequences to that as a leader. And so paying attention to that and taking responsibility for that action, knowing that you might need to have a discussion with somebody later, hey, how did you make that feel? How did that make you feel? Kind of reconnecting with them as a person is part of the responsibility of a leader. And so I think one of the tricks that I have, or one of the strategies that I have leaders really think about is not only what are they doing in those situations where they have to turn it on and off, but who are they? Who are they? Which mask are they wearing? Right? We all have different pieces of us that we need to show up as. And which piece of me am I going to use? Which skill, which part of my toolbox, which mask, which hat am I going to put on in this situation? And it requires a lot of self-awareness and a lot of understanding the impact. I always say that we are 100% responsible for the impact we have on other people. And just understanding that impact. And the other thing it also leads to is being open to feedback, being able to listen to other people so that when they tell you, hey, I appreciate that you were that way, or hey, that hurt me that you were that way, this is all part of the responsibility of being able to manage your emotional intelligence well. And there are situations where you have to go one way or the other. For example, if someone in your family or in your workplace is really, really hurting, that's time to really crank up the empathy, really listen, show them that you care. That's not the time to tell them what to do. So there's a balance, always a balance.